Thank you all for watching my videos and supporting me. Today I will build a small program using Python. I will build a circuit board and I will show you how the Python program will control the circuit. I need some accessories to build the circuit. I have already bought these accessories. This is breadboard, resistors, LED and two wires. Breadboard is a simple device which I will use to build the circuit. You can see there are 5 holes in each row and 5 holes in each column. All these 5 holes in each column are interconnected and all these 5 holes in each row are interconnected. You can see there are 5 rows which are interconnected and next 5 rows are also interconnected. I will use this breadboard to build this small circuit. This is LED. You can see it has 2 legs. One leg is little bit longer. It is positive and the shorter one is negative. These are 2 wires with male and female connector. I will use these 2 wires to connect to the positive and negative legs of LED. Let me insert this LED in the breadboard. So I have inserted the positive leg on the left side and the negative on the right side. Now I will insert the resistor and I will connect the resistor to the positive leg. To connect the resistor to the positive leg, I am inserting one end of the resistor to one hole in the same column and another end of the resistor in one hole of different column. Now this resistor and the positive leg are interconnected. Now I will use this wire to connect to one end of the resistor and one end of the LED. So this red wire I am using to connect to the negative end of the LED. And this white wire I am using to connect to the resistor. That will in turn connect to the positive leg of the LED. The circuit is ready. This is a simple circuit. The red wire is connected to the negative leg of LED. The white wire is connected to the positive leg of LED through the resistor. In some circuit you will see people are not using the resistor. Don't do this. It may burn your LED. It may burn your Raspberry Pi. What will happen when we connect these other 2 ends to the GPIO pin of Raspberry Pi? Current will flow through this white wire, through the resistor and turn on the LED. If the LED need more power or more current, it will draw that current from Raspberry Pi and the Raspberry Pi may burn down. So to protect the Raspberry Pi and to protect the LED, use the resistor over here. This will protect both LED and Raspberry Pi. this is one important chart that came along with Raspberry Pi 3 toolkit. This chart shows what are the GPIO pins available in Raspberry Pi 3 toolkit. You can see there are 40 pins starting from 1. This is 40. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So each pin has different purpose. Pin 6 used for ground. Pin 7 is GPIO 4. For this circuit, we will use pin 6 and pin 7. Pin 6 we will use to connect to the negative leg of LED, and pin 7 we will connect it to the positive leg of LED. So you can see this Raspberry Pi has 40 general purpose input output pins. This is pin 1, pin 2, pin 3, pin 4, pin 5, pin 6, pin 7, pin 8. I will use pin 6 and 7 for this circuit. Pin 6 is for ground, which I will connect to the negative leg, and pin 7 is GPIO4, which I will connect to the positive leg. I have connected this red wire to pin 6 and this white wire to pin 7. The white wire is connected to the positive leg of LED and red wire is connected to the negative leg of LED. Pin number 6 is for ground, and pin number 7 is for GPIO4. Now the circuit is ready. Now I will write the Python program to switch on and switch off the LED. Now to connect Raspberry Pi from your laptop, you need to open the VNC viewer. I have already opened this VNC viewer. This is the correct IP address for the Raspberry Pi. I will select this. It is connected. So to program in Raspberry Pi, we need an editor. I will get the editor from here. Programming. This editor I can use. Let's see if it is working fine or not. Seems it is working fine. So let's go ahead, write a program to switch on and switch off the LED. New file. First I will add a command line, LED blink. Now I need to import two files. This is rpi.gpio, which I am mentioning as GPIO, and second file is time. Now I need to set this GPIO to either BCM or board.
There are two options available. One is GPIO BCM and another is GPIO dot board. In this program we will use GPIO dot BCM. BCM stands for Broadcom SoC channel.
So this is the chart that came along with the Raspberry Pi 3 toolkit. The number inside this circle are called board number, GPIO.board, and the number over here like GPIO4, GPIO17 are called GPIO.BCM number. BCM stands for Broadcom SoC channel. For this programming we will use this BCM number like GPIO4, which is actually representing pin number 7 on the board.
So I have set up GPIO pin 4 for the output. Now let's type the next statement. Pin number 4 and true. So the this statement will switch on the LED. This will wait for 1 second, and then again I'll switch off the LED. I'll change it to false. And again it will wait for 1 second. So I'll copy these four statements 3 times. So it will first switch on, wait for 1 second, then switch off, switch on, wait for 1 second and switch off, and go on. And next, when everything is done, I will clear this pin number 4 output. Now it is ready. I'll save it as LED test dot py. Py stands for Python. Save. Now I run it from here. F5. It's running. Let's see how it is coming circuit board.
Now you can see it started working 3 times and stopped.